Hi, and welcome to the next installment of the LTTV Book Talk. Today, once again, we have Noelle from LaGrange Public Library, and she's going to tell us about our next book. Could you tell us a bit about this book, How I Live Now?
Sure.
The title?
Sure. How I Live Now by Meg Rossoff is Rossoff's first book, and it's a stunning debut. It's just amazing. The book takes place in an alternate present, and it starts out in Manhattan, where our heroine, Daisy, who's 15 years old, lives with her dad and her stepmother. And her stepmother is very young, and she and Daisy do not get along, and she's just become pregnant, and Daisy is just not comfortable in this whole new family situation. So her dad is, and she's kind of a wiseacre. I mean, she's got kind of a smart mouth on her. And her dad decides that she should go overseas, change of scenery, and live for a while with her aunt in London, her deceased mother's sister, who she's never met. And this aunt has four children, so she's got these four cousins that Daisy has never met. So she sets out for London, and when she arrives, she's greeted by her cousin Edmund, who's 14 years old, and he actually drives up in a Jeep smoking a cigarette. And so she's thoroughly blown away by this, by his, you know, his sophistication. And so she settles in with them, and for the first few days, it's absolutely wonderful. Her aunt is part of the peacekeeping force in the United Nations, and so she has a lot to do with politics and international politics. And she has these four cousins. One is Edmund, that she first met. One is Piper, who is a little girl who's about 6 years old. And then she has two older male cousins. But everyone's around her age, and so she really has a good time with them. And they live on this farm outside of London, and it's this beautiful pastoral setting. They have chickens and cows and geese and goats and everything. And so she settles in, and she's there the first day, and the next day her aunt has to leave to go to Oslo because there are countries that are threatening Great Britain.
Okay.
And so her aunt leaves, and it's just the five of the kids there by themselves. And it's not clear in the book what happened to her
the
father of this family. So anyway, the aunt goes off, leaves the five kids to fend for themselves, and it's just great. I mean, there's no grown-ups around. They're living in the countryside.
So they love it, I bet.
And they just love it. And as a matter of fact, Daisy starts to lose some of the chip on her shoulder, and she starts eating a little bit better, and she falls in love with Edmund, which is
her cousin.
Yeah, well, that's true, and there's kind of an ew factor in America, but in Great Britain,
does this have somewhat to do with the fact that you mentioned that it was an alternate? Did you say alternate? I forget what you use exactly.
Yeah, so it was like an alternate present.
There we go.
One of the clues you have to this is not only is Great Britain at on the brink of war with an unnamed enemy, but also her cousin Edmund has this power of mind reading. He knows what's going on in people's thoughts, and he doesn't make a big deal of it.
Right.
And as a matter of fact, it seems like he doesn't really like this gift.
No, he doesn't.
Right. It makes him very uncomfortable. And Daisy discovers this and kind of figures it out. So what happens is war breaks out, and her aunt, who's in Oslo, never comes back. She's actually killed, and they find this out later.
Okay.
And at first, things don't change very much. After all, they're on a farm. They're isolated. They've got plenty of fresh food. They've got plenty to eat. And things go on for a couple of weeks. But then some militiamen come to the house, and they discover that there are no grown-ups living there. And they decide, well, that can't be good.
Right.
So what they do is they split up the family. They decide the girls are going to go one place and the boys are going to go another. And they sort of farm these kids out. They split the family up and farm them out. And the kids protest. I mean, this isn't something they want to stay together.
Want.
Right. But they're loaded into these trucks, and like right in front of them, as if to sort of underscore the seriousness of everything, men are getting killed, just blown up by bombs, shot in the face. I mean, it actually truly is war. And for the first time, they've suddenly realized this they are alone, and the only people they can depend on are each other. And so once they are sort of farmed out into these families, and they lose track of each other, their whole goal, Daisy kind of takes over, and you only know what's going on with her, and her goal is to
reunite.
She wants to take Piper and just search the countryside and search all of Great Britain to find the rest of her cousins.
I see.
And so that's really what the rest of the story is
that
about.
That sounds very interesting, and if you want to learn more about this, you can go to LagrangePublicLibrary.org, or just come to the LaGrange Public Library and check this book out. And make sure you tune into the next book talk here on LTTV.